Hello. Well, it's warm where you are. It's cold where I am. We're down in the south. New Zealand, to be specific. It's your painter in residence, Imprints McCarthy. I'm going to give you another lesson on skies. But do me a favor. Get some value from this. Leave me a comment. There's other ways that you can help support me too, but that'd be the least you could do, right? Least you could do. I'm in the sky kick. Now I got the zoom out here. The photo's actually going to be down here too. But I'm going to start drawing. And I just want to point out some things, some issues. Beautiful photo. It's just a random pick I got years ago off of. Is that my phone? Might even be the phone telling me it's low on power. Was my friend. Okay, so I've got this zoomed out. We're gonna talk for a minute. All right, beautiful. We're responding, but there's a couple really things we're gonna watch out for, and I'm gonna be avoiding them in the drawing, and I'll be pointing out things, and you won't know what I'm talking about. One is the super wide angle, and this is actually a zoom in of that photo. So everything's gotten real slim. This is tiny. We'll be blowing that up. But the main thing I want to point out to you is this arc. I'm going to be breaking that up. You see that big, big giant arc? We're going to bust it up. We're going to get more variance in there. And this sort of bothers me too. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, I love the color and we will be using it, you know, but I just wanted to point those things out to you real quick, okay? And we're back. I'll turn this down a little. You don't need that. I don't need that noise, Mike. Alright. Now, members area. God bless the members. You guys are great. I'm giving you guys 4K and no ads. I don't know how many ads YouTube is sticking in this. This is the other thing too, and this is a lesson for all of you, you know. I just feel like doing skies, and so I'm doing them. So follow those impetuses in your own work, you know what I mean? Don't fight it, you know, that's the thing. Like today is actually supposed to be in the next study, but I did a study after Charles Warren Eaton yesterday, and I'm just tired, you know. It takes a lot out of me doing those master studies, just, you know, as opposed to riffing on some reference, which is what we're going to do today. I've got to be real exacting. I've got to try and match what's there, you know. I don't get stressed or anything, but and actually where I was at the end of the day, it was like, I can't even use this for why I was doing it, which basically was going to be for my book. But I'm looking at it. I'm thinking it might be fine. I'm still thinking about it. That's the demo section. The book's basically done. I'm working on demos. What we're doing here, see that big difference in the color there? So, you know, if you were working on top of that without hitting it with that oil, you'd be making value judgments based on a lie, okay? So a lot of times I do this off camera. I did a beautiful one earlier in the week that basically the sky bit didn't get recorded. You know, I'm very sad about that. Could be a bit of my OCD. What's that? Obsessive compulsive. Yeah, I'm pretty obsessive about liking to record my work. So, and you can see if I didn't get, oh, that's nice, eh? Right. Now I have a grid. You'll see the grid on the photo. I'm going to put the grid here, even though I'm going to be changing a lot. The grid just helps me get my bearings. We're going to be using black today because I know I'm going to be doing this today. I don't have a choice. So I do have a choice. Of course I have a choice. But that is the parameters. Parameters is get her done. Get her done. Maybe a 2-3 hour video. And Yeah, you know what? I made a whole extra $20 off of Google this month. I ain't mad at Google, though. I think they're great. You know? I think YouTube's great, I should say. Google, I don't know. Oh, you're making all the money. Well, but look, I mean, they host a zillion videos. That costs money. You know? You can put your videos up without even making them widely public. And that's costing them money. So, I ain't mad at them. We're partners. Okay, this is 3.5. So, the grid... You can make this grid, by the way. Oops. You can make this grid. You could keep dividing it in half and then half again. You don't need little squares for your grid. You can work with little rectangles and avoid a bunch of math. This is just dividing in half. You could divide in half again. I don't recommend it though, because who cares about the reference photo? The reference photo, beautiful photo. It's just inspiration. Now the other thing we need to do is get our horizon line done, which is one of the reasons I'm painting. I'm gonna go a little, well actually I already added a bunch to the bottom. The reference down there. That's an evolution for me because I don't like sharing my reference. I really don't. But whatever, I'm over it now. I'm over it as far as these demos go. For a lot of my painting, I'm not ever going to do that. I don't need that. But yeah, I'm in sky teaching mode, and you're maybe in sky learning mode. Okay. So first thing we want to do, all we're doing is in black, so if you don't see me lift up the palette, I do think it's kind of good. I'm going to go, and it's not in the reference, but we need another shape here. Okay. Well, the other thing I like is that little bit of that little stripe of whatever underneath there. I think that's awesome. It's reflection is what it is. This will be way less dark. And I won't be going as dark as it is in the reference either, so. Is a super worn in Robert Simmons Signet series. I'll take my glasses on. Can't just be copying the reference. That's why so many of you have problems painting skies. You see the beauty of it. You think, oh my goodness, I gotta copy that. Well, I bet you'll find that in pretty short order. It's a fool's game. It's a fool's game. You take inspiration. Straight. side of the brush, give me a mass sort of approach. Now it's a really long format, so we can get away with quite a lot of longy type stuff. So let's bring in some things from the other side. I really do like all these pale yellows and oranges, so I'm going to give them a little more room to breathe. Last week I did a study on, because I had a custom sort of commission lesson on a Arthur Matthews. That painting turned out really nice. It's not completely done, but so it's enabling us to do some erasing. Let's see how I've broken up. That was just a boom. But not that we're done. We're just... So sometimes it's really valuable. Set up a random bit. There's a guy who teaches... see if I can remember his name. I remember the name of his book. It's Creative Illustration. Andrew Loomis. Brilliant book. You can find PDFs of that online. And it also got reprinted. It was so... popular, but he had on one section there, he's brilliant, very, very smart guy, and a brilliant illustrator and artist, and all his books are good, I recommend them. They're not really landscape painting oriented, but I had a career as an illustrator for years, so I have an interest in it. Avoiding these long, streaky bits, breaking things up. Anyway, old Andrew, he had one thing where he would, a system for coming up with compositions. Very interesting. He would just start with all these random lines and then start drawing diagonals and horizontals and vertical lines through the... And eventually a sort of pattern would emerge. And that's a great idea because so... As human beings, we are pattern recognition machines. I mean, well, not really about machines, but you know what I'm saying. Hopefully you know what I'm saying. Pattern recognition is a thing, and it's what all of us do. Some of us do it intuitively, and others of us do it in a different way. But either way, patterns and pattern recognition is a real key to art. So, you can set up random deal, and then you start working on that, you start building on that, and informed by the photo, but not a slave to the photo. Inspiration is what that photo is. I do like this. Not far off from the time to get rid of that grid. To really appraise what it is I want to do in the center, it's time for the grid to go away. So this is the same cloth that I or towel I used to oil off the board, so it's going to be a good candidate for erasing here. Grid served its purpose. After a certain point in time, like, you might be tempted to keep it, thinking it's going to keep helping you. It won't. It's just going to mess you up after a certain point. At that point, we've reached. And I like that, but one of the reasons I kept doing it over and over, I think it might be a little weird, so I'm not gonna lock myself into that little cloud. But I'm pretty happy with what I'm doing here. Too much oil, that's what that is. That could happen if you dip in the oil and Tennessee's always want to leave something open there, but we'll see. It can be kind of arbitrary what's going to be light and dark, and then it may be the opposite of what's in the reference as well. So, a lot of times, loud, straight. That's a stylistic thing, but it could be that. There might be times you feel like you're lost. My advice is just keep persevering. And then don't get all so frustrated you start scrubbing the painting down or whatever. I almost did that last night myself. Like, oh, what could frustrate you, the master? Well, I'll tell you what. And that's Charles Warren Eaton. There's these like leafless trees, which is not one of my favorite things to paint. I don't like them. Looks brilliant in his work. I'm not saying that it's a bad thing to paint. I'm saying I don't like painting them. Anyway, then if I am going to paint them, and I wasn't videotaping, I would have just waited for the painting to dry, hit it with a coat of liquid, and then carefully painted the trees on the dry painting surface. But because painting these trees over the wet, if you let sit for a while, I'm like, this is clouds, so I probably won't, but I might do this sometimes at foliage. Going on with the drawing is just having some bits for imagination. That's too much paint there. Nice. Don't know what we do down here. I usually don't worry much about it. I left quite a lot of it, so yeah, sometimes I do. So this is what I advised you, and I did this on a some grass. Okay, so grass, kind of like grass. What did grass got to do with oceans? Well, good question. It can be an area where there's not a lot going on. So there, you know, I'm just gonna keep repeating myself. Maybe at some point it'll stick. You create some patterns. Like, I'm not gonna do this. If it was grass, I might do a zigzag, like a Z. I ain't gonna do that here. I'll do some horizontals, because we know it's horizontals and verticals, but I don't get into a lot of verticals. So I'm just gonna start putting in a few. And of course, we got like subtle reflections of the clouds. Whoa. Whoa, that's pretty strong. That's okay though. Like, the idea is to get something going on. Get a little bit lost, so you gotta get found. That's how you get into the scene. That's how we get to see what you're gonna do, right? And you don't have to be a genius. All you have to be is a worker. Work, you know? This is going to be so fun to paint today. I mean, I'm already having fun, don't get me wrong, but... Notice I'm holding this brush, just keeping me from thinking, like, holding like this, you know, that might be how you hold a pencil, and there'll be times you'll see me do that in a painting. But this allows me to work with masses, shapes. There's that pole, that little, you see that in the reference. I kind of like some of that. Bring in some of that here. That's gotten a bit dark. It's okay. That mostly open. Well, it's looking a little like Swiss cheese, so let's get rid of some of that. The spaces between where things are going to be light and going to be dark are too... I need to open up some sky a bit, so... There's paint in that brush. This is not great. It's okay. It's a process. And don't worry too much about that, because these are defined, kind of. I'm trying not to define them too much, because essentially they're going to be just loose wood. which is in color, but it's good to have that pattern there. It is some of it probably will survive into the final. That. I don't like the top of that. Now, there is a donation button. You're getting value. I'm helping you with the skies. Help me out. You know what? We're doing okay. I'm not complaining. I'm just saying. You got the funds. Help me out. If you don't, then don't worry about it. This is one of the things that's great about the internet, interweb. Free info. Don't get me wrong, I take advantage of a lot. In fact, just someone, that channel, I don't know if you've, the channel Moon on YouTube is amazing, I love it. And he's got a membership option now, like I do. Same price, I would love to be a member of his channel, but, I mean, we're just barely making it. Dollar-wise, like so many of you. So, again, don't worry about it. If you don't have any funds, don't worry about it. But if you do, if you can, join the members area, or you would have seen this in 4K with no ads. I think we're getting to a point of diminishing returns here. Anyway, I know in a lot of these I haven't said anything. And I really don't plan on saying much more today, so you don't have to go up so tired of asking for money. Yeah, well, if you don't ask, you don't get. Or, yeah, these paintings, this painting will be on the store. You think this is awesome? I don't know. I hope this one's going to be awesome. But there are some other ones that are definitely awesome, and they're affordable as shipping's included. That's my favorite way to be supported. No question. Alright, so this is a little tricky, but that bringing in a bit of that vertical, I think, is good. This guy needs to be some torque. Yeah, I'm pretty close to seeing drawing done here. As you can see in this reference image, the bottom here is light. Especially because this is pretty open, gonna be pretty open, but patches of color. I frankly think it's better to get these corners dark. It's a trope of mine, I know, and I'll admit it. On the vignette, you can see how that pulls us right in. We want to go, we're going to have this beautiful, you can see it in the reference image, the light blue here, it's going to be really beautiful. Did I just lighten that? I used to use that swirl technique a lot, by the way. So it can be kind of subtle. So I'm going to keep it subtle. Tying things together. Don't have shapes in isolation. Hey, how you doing? Oh, no trash, man. I got no trash. Okay. Still empty from your last time. Oh, you're not usually in here on Saturday, so, hey?
No, but Monday and Tuesday are going to be crap weather, and I'm probably not going to be here.
Well, and they did have the festival, too, so that won't support your weight.
It's a fantastic amount of rain over the next few days.
Great, that's what I want to hear. Well, at least it seems to be taking a break and drying out a little in between each storm, so... Yeah, I would thank God for that. Yeah, definitely. And yesterday was nice and warm and quite clement.
Yep.
Today it's all cold again. It's like every other day they're doing.
I know. It's like 8 degrees out there.
I can feel it in my toes. I don't know about you. But
I've got fairly warm boots on at the moment.
Well, me too. And warm socks, but I still got cold toes. And a heater.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Well, mind you, I'm my own heater because I'm moving around so fast.
Yeah, that's right. You're actually moving. I'm just moving my mouth.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you an interesting story I heard on the internet.
Okay. We'll make some colors. Make it quick. You don't get bored, eh? Well, I'm going to go watch that Wham video. Wake me up. That's all I'm going to do. Get a little music going. Background music. You can see the picture there. It is there. I hope it's there. Hope I remember that. Ooh, we lost our speakers. Should be okay. All right, so what do we got? We got that blue in the sky. Still working with ultramarine, which at first will hit you like, ew, it's all right. That is a tiny, not gonna use it. That's a lot of white, but it's a light blue, so got a little bit of yellow in there. The white kind of will keep it from going. Okay, that's loud enough. The white will kind of keep it from going. You know, green. When you hit that yellow in there, that's pretty good. Also, there's a little bit of a cyan-y type of thing, and to get the cyan from the blue, it's going to be a little bit yellow. That's a lot. That's a lot. Did he fly too close to the sun? We're blending it in, We need a decent amount in this painting anyway, so. A little more blue. A little white. Hope I'm not messing my drawing up too bad behind, but it's okay, we'll figure it out. Like that. A couple different blues. We'll probably do a little darker version at the top. I try and average things out. There'll be some lighter versions. Kind of go for the middle. That's good. That's ultramarine. Phthalo would have been a little better, but I got ultramarine on the palette. I'm using ultramarine. Now you could have two blues on your palette. Maybe that's real important to you. I don't know. That's me. What do I have two of my palette? I have two reds. Cool red, warm red, opaque, transparent. Three earth palettes. Burnt sienna. Actually, I should take you through all the colors here. You may not know. That's some lead white from yesterday. That's titanium white. The bleached version. That's titanium buff. The unbleached version. That's some cadmium yellow. That is yellow ochre. That's some lumber, very handy. That's Mike's green, won't be a factor in today's painting. So watch one of my other videos to find out what's in that. That's a tiny little bit of brown ochre from yesterday's painting. We'll get some orange on here. No, we won't do it now. Yes, we will, because we need it. We need it to do our work. I don't think there's a ton of oil gushing out in this. I hope not. With a little bit. That's cadmium orange. Very handy for skies, because you can hit that blue and get all kinds of compliments. As I've taught you before, unless you're new, if you're new, hey, welcome. Cad red, that'll be a factor, especially with those hot pinks there, you see. Burnt. That is burnt sienna, but it's actually fake burnt sienna. It's this, says burnt sienna, but they lie. Is on the thing here, it tells you what it is. It's transparent red iron oxide. And burnt sienna is not 100% transparent. This is, you can glaze with that all day. Burnt umber, that's a good color to have. Lizard crimson would be great for getting some purples and other magenta tones. Phthalo green, probably won't be a factor today. None of these will, permanent green light. Dioazine, probably will. Ultramarine blue, that's some lamp black, that's Mike's gray, that's a mix of mix. Did you have a drink at lunch? No. That's a mish of titanium white and ivory black or lamp black or ivory black, lamp black, same difference, by the way. It's all carbon black. And then some leftover mixtures from yesterday's paintings, so I think we'll probably use those up. Ooh, there was some oil in there. At least it's staying on the palette. There was my hesitation. Alright, so let's go spinning off into next most prominent color. That's a blue. I might go a little less blue on it. Let's just get it the right value to start. Actually, you know, it'd be a little nicer than that. Whoa, that's a little too dark. Really can only. That's nice. I like that, but I'm gonna put a little purple in it. A little purple. I think we might bring in some other things when we start doing the painting. I don't want to take all day on this because I know people get bored. In fact, this is the kind of thing that in every members area video has this, because I figure those people are serious about wanting to learn how I mix colors. Not to offend any of you, but some of you in the non-members place just looking for quick answers. All right, you know what? We're gonna make a complimentary blue here. A complimentary is when like blue is a complimentary of orange. Green is a complementary of red, and yellow is a complementary of purple. So we can get some warm grays going here. And then you might go, that looks icky. I'm gonna get some of this buff here. Also, let's check in some of this raw umber. Ah, it's exactly what I want. Maybe I need more of it, I don't know. We'll go with that for now. Definitely want more, but we'll make something like it that's similar, a different way. How about that? Let's make one from, let's make a color from this, well, you're drying up, aren't you? For a number. So you're going to get a gray. Kind of a gray. It's a taupey, browny gray. That might be good. Well, there's some dry chunks in that. Bring in some lead white. Will I use lead white on this? Don't know. It takes, act funny enough, dries very fast once you paint it, but that's quite nice. I like that. Maybe it's just a tiny bit of red. Oh, that's sweet. That's nice. I usually don't say sweet. That's a big thing everyone says out here. I don't know about where you went. Sweet. That's sweet. That's sweet. I think calling things sweet is better than calling things sick. especially with all the you know what that's been going around. So now, ooh, let me say. I like that just the way it is. We can maybe use it for something. Just sitting down there. This one too, oh, that's got a skin on it, but that bit in the center is good. Let's just pop them out. So those are from yesterday's paint. They're starting to set up and dry, but that's the good bits. You want to mix a little bit of that ready color. Ooh, don't you do it. Don't you do it. Crimson, funny enough, in a mix, like, white will wake up crimson, you see its true nature. Yeah, I mean, I could have got that with the cad red, too, but because I had that orange on my knife, I thought, oh, I'll just do it with the orange. Working the orange off the old crimson. That ain't bad. Didn't make very much of it, but that's alright. Let's make some of that light pale yellow on the bottom there and call that a day. Keep in mind I didn't mix these two colors today. They're just there to remind me to use them. Well, we're making a mess here on my hands. Area with those little yellows. Let's make some of that. Let's start with this. This isn't so far off anyway. I see the tiny amounts I'm adding. I don't really want to darken it. I just want to give it a little. The beauty of that buff color, because a lot of times I'll take the white and I spend a lot of time just getting it to a buff sort of creamy place, so that saves a lot of time. Boom. Okay, let me take this off the clean it up, wipe it off. Weird sound just dropped off. May as well just restart here. Looks like it's acting up, and I can auction actually, you know what? This is 90% of the colors for the painting, really. What else is there but sky? A little bit of black. So,
we'll be back.
All right, we're back. Yeah, I mean, other than the dark and the land, it's all going to be some sort of thing. It's in the sky. This is a sky painting. So let's select a brush. I've had some nice success with these lately. Well, are you guys the same size or what? They're pricey. Look, this one's acting a little different, eh? We'll try this one today. Been having good luck with that brush. We're going to start with the blue. We got some oil. I was supposed to have a break, but I just got back, so that would be pretty decadent. We'll reward ourselves in the break when we get a good portion of the sky going. I want to keep this video to, you know, a couple hours, 2.5 tops. So I know you guys get bored. We don't need these glasses. Now, I don't know about blue there. That's in the reference. You can see it. I don't know about it. I'm going to reserve what I do. That's our mixed color. Okay, hell. And the magic of raw umber. They go, that's icky. Well, you'll see. You don't know everything. That blue without it looks fake. Let's get a little flavor of purple. That's nice. I'm gonna start modulating right at the bat. Watch out, your intervals are too samey. Well, I have been using cat yellow, and I could have used yellow ochre. I don't know. Wow, that's nice. It's a little lighter than the reference, but. I think I got everything figured out here in this guy just because there's a drawing, and I don't. I'm gonna modulate. I'm gonna go some of this blue, but also a little crimson. A little more blue, a little more crimson. We love to modulate. So what do? through its blue identity pretty good. Traditional titanium white. Yeah, so you hear me talking, but you know, I'm kind of talking to myself sometimes. I remember early days of the live version of this channel. I mean, the channel was 15 minute videos for, for 6-7 years, something like that. But, don't make me sit here and think about it right now. I don't know. I don't know how long it was. But after a period of time, I started doing the live thing, and somebody said, which gave me the point, says, well, it sounds like what you're, this must be your inner dialogue. It's like, he found me out already. I already found out. After this, it's just, you know, what I'm saying in my head, trying to remember things. Okay, so let's wipe this brush off. All of this is not blue sky. I'm doing the blue sky bits first. So I think I'm gonna leave it there for now. Okay. Yeah, wiping on your time, eh? No need to actually get the palette cleared off. So up here, what was I talking about? I want gray. I don't care. I don't care what's in there. So I'm going to go for my gray. And I think I'm just going to start off with this gray I mixed without much adulteration at all. I put a little oil in that. No, I can't go much further than that without saying, oh, what am I modulating? What am I modulating to? I got some of this nice brown, brown ochre here. Hey? Great color. Not a lot of modulating, but it's some. That's some of that warm gray. Right, we're gonna modulate. But here I think we're gonna modulate with some of this blue sky color. space or time. Oh, well, we got this other brush. Why waste it, huh? Keep yourself, you want to learn something from me here today, keep yourself from constantly just carrying on with that same color. Here's a little bit of brown umber, brown. We need some oil, it's feeling a little stiff. Brown. Burnt umber. No, I'm not losing it. Different brains, folks. Nice, it's not different enough there. This I want to go to that deeper blue. And that won't be different enough. I want to tell you what'll make it different. Some of this. Oh, that was a little bit of old cat orange in there too. Darker, and you know I'm gonna do it. I'm a rule breaker. How black, eh? We'll do a little of this nice raw umber too. I lost most of it because all the paint in my brush. Now that probably is too dark. I did the burnt sienna. I want some complexity. It's not too dark. It's not as dark as I wanted it. And I do want this that dark. Just do. Might be making it lighter after. Let's go ahead and marry these together. Probably the dark I'm doing seriously. I don't even drink, so I didn't have any drinks. Mooing. It's probably going to be too dark. I'm going to probably paint over it. That's fine, though. That was a bit of a technique. like that. No. I want it kind of dark, but I want more blue in that. We can start with this. Just check out some blue. A lot of them. Pretty dark. Well, let's just give it a little flavor of crimson. I was thinking of the deoazine, but I think crimson would be nice. That's going to be dark enough. You know what, in the reference, you can see the reference. It's got like an aqua feeling to it. Ooh, I can do that. I will. Now, be careful with green and skies. It ain't really a sky color, but you know, a little bit of that ain't gonna hurt. It's lovely. Pause one sec. Yeah, I was gonna get some more of these. Don't have a lot of money, but I got some Google money, which is thank you. That's a big part of that is your membership. I love this for my skies. I know it's a pricey brush. You're gonna stop that chewing. I don't need that as background in my life. Okay, a little bit more of this, but I'm going to modulate. Oh, what's he doing? Okay, so it's my way around that. A little white. See how that kind of de-green defined it. Some of the darkness I wanted here.
Mark?
Yeah. Hey, good one. Yeah. You might be saying, hey, where's all those pretty colors? When are you going to do that? I'm going to, don't you fret. Yeah, it's time to get in some of these pinks, hey? Just done used all the blue. Okay. I'm getting some of those pinks and taupes and things now. Wiping off my brush. Actually, I take a little momentary break here. We'll be back. Actors had to use the, you know, restroom. Yeah, so you get to a point where you know, okay, whoa, where's all my pretty colors? You know, you were probably seeing it a little while back. But keep in mind that just because something's there, it doesn't mean something else isn't going on top. Right? Set it with a little bit of cad red. Just want to get into a different mode. That's pretty. That more pretty. So I'm gonna add some white and some cad red. You know, a little pinker would be nice. Let's keep going with some yellow. And of course a little white. Is that crazy having that so against it? That's the thing I love about skies, man. You know, there are some rules. I'm not sure what they are, but there are. Mostly like the rule about the intervals, you know, like don't have three shapes the same, that kind of thing. Well, I want to keep modulating on that. I think we'll go with some orange. White again, because I want to go into dark. A, B, M. Always be modulating. Some cat yellow. off the brush. A little bit more pink. Well, it's a hot pink mix, which really isn't that hot. Let's go lighter on that. Redder. I want a pink. We can muddy it up with some of these other colors. Let's start. Remember I told you those dark clouds would be too dark? Well, you'll see. I know, because I've been through this before. Alright, so how about we hit some of this with some of this blue? How about that? What do you think? Some of this, I think I mix that. I don't remember. I just saw not that long ago that movie Idiocracy. That's so funny if you haven't seen that. Watch that one. Shut up! It's about a guy that ends up going being put in a suspended animation. He's just 100% average IQ, but because all the people that are not that bright keep having children, you know, it goes 500 years in the future, and he's like a genius. He's like the genius of the age. A little more of that pink. Flatten it back out. Come out of that with some of this wood over here. I picked that because the value is about the same. Get some nice modulations going. very dark to not so. Wiping off my brush. Wiping off all that pigment. See? Can't be afraid to get the paint out, reset. Go, not that kind of reset. But, and then here do a bit of just wiping the brush off. So, I mean, it's not a clean brush, but there's not really a lot of, there's barely any pigment in. And that is what you call edge strategy, a number 11 and 95. That's nice, I like that. So, I haven't abandoned the pink yet. I like this, it's kind of something like this more taupey tone. That was left over from the painting the other day. It's very brown, so we're going to add some crimson to it. Some a little more sky appropriate. I see there's a few chunks in there. One another pinky tone, but something different, something else we can play off of. And I want more crimson and more white. That's light white. Ooh, like that there. We don't have a lot left, but let's put some here. Dark, but we'll worry about that. We'll get everything in, then we'll worry. We'll worry some more. one's different, and I could use the same exact reference, make it another painting very different. Let's just get this. I see some peach. That's some cat yellow. Hey, how you doing? Uh-oh.
Oh,
have you met Jerry?
Jerry?
He's crazy. He loves people.
Oh, hello, gorgeous.
I've got to say hello.
Yeah, Mom's a dog person.
Oh, well, he loves... This is Mike. Hi.
Sorry to interrupt you.
No, it's all good. I'm here to be interrupted.
You're beautiful.
Well, thank you for giving him a pet. He's, he lives for that.
Go on, honey. You've got to do
Come
something.
On, that's enough. Thank you. That's good, thank you. Ooh, you got some good pets there, Jerry. This is Peach. I don't know what you're lonely. Like that. Now back to that gray I was talking about. I've got some of this here. That again I think was left over, but we'll just plump that into pretty okay. Warm by gray, I mean like a warm gray. We may get back into some cool grays too, you know, as we... That's nice. That's the value in one end, so we can kind of... A little darker there. Oh, and we have some here. Not too much, because I need to bring some color there. We have gray, 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 gray. Color, what color? Purple. Purple has been absent from this deal. If I do it there, I gotta do it at some other spots too, but it's time. I don't even want any more of that same crimson-y. Nice. Could be just a thing over here too. I was wondering what to do there. you bet we're going to modulate. Cad red. Give us a different kind of purple. Lighter. Bring a little more of that deoazine. Okay, we need to top up our CAD red. Top up is not an American expression, but hey, I don't live in America anymore. You know, honestly, we want somewhere that ultramarine blue. Oh, the cobalt? Are you sure? Okay. Well, I could have put I keep getting forced to use ultramarine because I keep putting ultramarine down. Some black and a little more blue. Is that out of the realm of modulation? I don't know. this might be a good color for one of these shapes back here. And we'll go with the lighter. Welcome. We're gonna finish this off to be pink. I don't want it too bright because I'm planning on putting those darkening that though. So we'll be adding that. See ya. You too. All right. So I'm feeling like I gotta take just a second to actually, you know what, instead of pulling this off the brush. Clean up this palette a little bit. Nice. Now we're going to get in some lighter bits on top of these, so don't think that we're done. We're not. Process. Here my palette. at that point where I got to think about things, they're going to have a little bit of a reset here. So what I was thinking is I got to get this this bit done here. So my brush is polluted. My oil's polluted. I'm gonna come in with some black and the pollutedness. Just see what that gives me. And I want that pretty dark. That's nice. There was a lot of red predominating there. That dark. That's gonna seem pretty dark. And if you can see the reference, it's just black there, but that's plenty dark. So we're gonna modulate. You know we are. And I'm gonna modulate to purple, but if I do it with just deoazine, it's gonna give me a headache. So what I'm going to do, deoazine alone, what I'm going to do is make me a little so I can actually see the deoazine. Because if I popped in that deoazine into that, just all, everything can get real dark, too dark, and wouldn't be good for the purposes of the modulations. See, that's good. Further. I'll think of it. I guess gray. Gray and more purple. Some very subtle modulating. What the bottom one is a little lighter. But you can see it's effective. You got, just as opposed to, you know, you see one color, you paint everything one color, you think you're done. You think you're being efficient, but what you're being is silly, because you gotta have payoffs everywhere you go, everywhere you go. Everywhere we go, we get the payoff, so nice. Some of what's on my palette. And what we don't need is a lot of features on this, because some of this gray here. I know I want it darker in the corners, but not as dark as that land shape. That's nice. some more blues. Yep, there's other stuff in that brush, it's okay. Blue. I actually want a blue that's very clean. I got the cobalt out. So that, what's left of this color, it was painted there, but let's see with that blue, probably the perfect color for hair. Square. Okay. I said what I want to say with the glue. gonna get some lighter colors. Everything else is pretty much gonna have to be light to make this work. That's just some of that buff, what's left. The beep, that's a warning. Thank God, because it looks like I forgot to clear off the card that I stuck in there, which really would have been frustrating. And I'd be talking to myself. That's that color we just made. It's kind of some of that blue with some of the things. Bingo, that's smelly. Let's finish off that little red bit there. I should have. Okay, and titanium white. Pop some orange in that. Lots of times too, just varying the pressure. As I paint, you get very different effects. Oops. I want that edge pretty tight. Not that tight, but we'll go over it again. No pigment. That's nice. Time for some of this yellow. That yellow. See the reference, a little thicker than in the reference, but I'm gonna go orangey here. Don't know what else to do. I want it moving and changing as it goes over here, so. Orange was my choice. That's nice, see? Chunks of old paint, just when I don't want you. Chase you around. Before I get too carried over that, we're gonna just finish this off, and it's gonna be light blue. Gonna basically clean my brush with white. Tiny bit of blue. A little tiny bit of blue. I don't want it dark, but And I know that's too sharp. And if you've been with me a while, you go, hey, Mike, you said never to put anything too sharp because then you're going to have to. Well, this is the exception. This is the exception. Because we've got a strategy. Strategy starts with wiping the brush off. We already did it one time, so don't be surprised to see me do it again. It's edge strategy. 5,300,742. That off, especially for you to this dark one. Wipe that off real good. It's a little sharper than I want, but it's not to say I won't do something else there on that area yet. Because I use my brush to mix it, I gotta wipe it off because it's too much. I only need a little bit. Bluish. They run it darker though. Oh man. So now I gotta wipe off my brush. All over again, twice, double wipe it, wipe it off, go back into some white, I gotta fix that, as I got carried away, I want that pretty clean there. Good. just don't have to wait. I ain't quite. More light blue with a different blue. Hopefully it'll be okay. Hope it'll be okay. You're burning your head, Pinky. That's right, I just put a bunch of caddy oil in there and some more white because Just grabbing some random board color. And I got too much paint on my brush, I already know it. Gotta go later. Thank you. darker version of that. It's a little yellow. More yellow. No, no barking, no growling, thank you. I mean it. If you continue, you're going to have a real problem on your hands. When you choose not to listen to me, it makes trouble. It was worth it. I don't want it. I don't. Stop. All right, may as well get these colors in here that I've been planning on doing since the beginning. They don't seem quite bright enough now. But stop it. Jerry, give it a rest. Stop it. Stop. Thank you.
gonna take a little break.
Right, we're getting close. We're getting close. Clean my palate. Need to do now, because we are getting close, is just fill up, cover that painting all together. No, I ain't gonna stop Marjolaine. You can't stop me. Well, there was some of that in my brush. This needs work. A few other areas. I'm worried about this being too dark. Kind of like it though, but like I say, once we have everything in there, it'll be easier to make some judgments. And you know, the fact of the matter is, like, board color's kind of cool there, so. that's lead white because I'm too lazy to get me any more titanium. The chewing and itching.
Thank you.
Neutrally color there. Mix that color. I just wiped it off my brush. What I want to do here is just kind of lighten them.
It takes a minute for your perception to kick in.
Here.
takes a minute for your perception to kick in.
I don't tend to like that kind of thing where everything's real stabby. Wonder if I can deal with that just without mixing that white. That wasn't a good move. Especially since I don't have any titanium white on my palette. I don't want to squeeze any more on. I got this lead white. Thank you. time to go, really. It's a good sign you're done when you're looking for things to do and you can't find anything. Stop the itching. Thank you. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. And obviously, I can keep tweaking. But I ain't gonna. Just gonna let it be what it is. Pretty good in the camera. All right. Thank you for joining me today. Hopefully you learned a bunch. You know, I'm going to address that. Well, let's get this over so we can do a nice full zoom in. Take good care, stay out of trouble.